The one thing we all have in common, if we're lucky, is that we are going to get old. It's a wonderful thing when you add years to your life.
Age-friendly is a concept that helps us organize how to think about how to age well. There's a physical component, a social component, economic component, environmental component. It's really a holistic view of how communities can be organized so that they best meet the needs of the older adults who live there. In 2006, I got an email, and that email said, the World Health Organization is doing a global age-friendly cities research project. So I agreed to do the study.
Portland was the first and only U.S. city to participate in 2006, along with 31 other cities.
Currently in our systems of government, we talk about equity from a racial ethnic perspective, and that's great, but when we look at age intersections with equity, there's some questions that need to be answered, such as, are there certain populations that are advantaged or disadvantaged? If we think about age as it relates to housing tenure, income, health, there are a lot of unanswered questions at this point.
You never arrive. You never say we are age friendly. It's we're becoming age friendly. It's an asset model where it approaches all individuals in a community as having something to give. Age is one of those key ingredients of diversity. Diverse teams end up working better. We need to see all ages as assets and how they can work together.
We are all reaching for the same goal, whether it's explicit in our missions or not, which is to make a better place and a community that will support people regardless of their age, ability, income, race, etc.
Everyone wants to feel respected. They want to feel that they are valued.
The whole phrase, building a community for all ages, speaks to both now and for people not yet born.
As I look at my new granddaughter, I look at the world I want for her is the same things that I want for all of us as we age. If we can achieve that, then we've achieved great things.